Hi everyone, this is Honeywell, and I'm playing Banished, and we're back with episode 3 of The Perfect Town. In this episode, we're going to go ahead and finish our tailor and get our second forester's hub set up, because food is going to quickly become an issue. We have more people being born, and we haven't increased our food capacity. So that's what we're going to do today. While I have the game paused, I'm going to go ahead and place these buildings real quick. We already know where I want them to go. During the first episode of the series, you saw all of this planned out already, so it should come as no surprise. Get our woodcutter placed too, even though we don't really need him right now, but yeah, since we're placing everything. And one more. We're going to be clearing resources from this area shortly, so let's get a stockpile set up over here so they'll be more efficient. Okay, yeah, there we go. Well, now let's just get it built. Go ahead and unpause the game, take a look at who we have here. We're gonna need leather for our tailor, so I'm gonna go ahead and up our hunters, so hopefully we can get a little bit more in there. Now this is a great setup, and it's perfectly efficient, but the building placement actually isn't ideal. Let's get another gatherer. The building placement isn't ideal, and that's okay. But as you can see, all of this mountain area is taking up potential production. So that's also another reason why we're getting our second forest hub up and running as soon as possible. It's just to take the strain off of these buildings over here. Now they're still going to produce a lot of goods for us. But these buildings over here actually have the potential to produce a lot more. I'm going to increase the priority on the barn to see if they get the hint that that's what I want built. And let's increase our speed as well. Oh, I have the game paused. That would be why nothing is happening. Ah, yes, food is low. We have a good amount of resources coming in, and well, we have enough queued up right now. No reason to add to that. I'm going to do a quick housing check. We're not quite ready, but close. Let's unpause one and see if we can get the materials over there as well. And food continues to struggle on the low end. Let's get that builder off and working on collecting resources, because as you can see, we do need them. They're finally working on that storage barn. Firewood is low. Firewood is gone. Someone back working there. And we need a builder as well. Our tailor is capped out, so we'll go ahead and take them off and see what we got going on there. Our builder should be working on our barn. And let's get our gatherer's hut unpaused and our hunting cabin. Why I keep messing around with this is I want the resources placed, but I just don't want this building built yet. Wood is good for now. Get another laborer. Okay. Now that's paused. Storage barn is done. Beautiful. Put that builder into the laborer's position so we can get the gatherer's hut and hunting cabin built. Yeah, we'll unpause the forester's lodge as well. Our stockpile over here is just about done. And when that's done, I'll queue up some farms over there to clear the area. Actually, that's not what I'm going to do next. We have a pretty big stockpile of stone. So I'm going to do a few buildings, a well and cemetery next. Okay, our stockpile is done. Excellent. And I'm pausing the game so I can take a look at what we have going on here real quick. I'm going to go ahead and use two builders and get these buildings knocked out. Now, I just had a laborer graduate, so let's find him. I have no idea where he's at. Where is he? Did I not have one? Let's pause this house again. Builder. student. Okay, yeah, we're not quite ready for that. We need another laborer to graduate, and then we'll be ready for that. Let's get our... Let's get our laborers gathering some resources. And I said we were going to do two buildings, so we'll get those set up too. We're going to lay out our cemetery, and we'll get a well in. Now both cemeteries and wells, increase happiness. In the early game, this really isn't a concern, because funnily enough, just building houses increases happiness. Your citizens get happy from births and weddings. So every time you build a house, a couple gets married, and they have children. So for a good portion of the game, that is really all you need. Well, that and some cemeteries too. Shoot, I can't see that. Did I put that in the right way? So really, building houses, a couple cemeteries, and your citizens are going to be perfectly happy while you're expanding. But just so you know, these buildings do have a happiness radius. For instance, wells have a radius of 20, so in every direction. So 20 tiles in every direction, and that's 20. All these buildings will receive a buff to happiness. And you can go in the other direction and see that placing this well right here actually includes all 12 of our houses in the area of effect. Okay, great. We have our gatherer's hut done, our hunting cabin, and our Forester's Lodge. Might as well get our woodcutter up while we're at it. And as you can see, we have lots of babies being born. I'm going to reduce our builders by one, and let's get our blacksmith and herbalist on for a bit. And we have a stockpile of leather too. Okay, let's decrease our builder and put our tailor on. And what we allowed to happen here is we allowed the workers at the gatherer's hut to split off into this gatherer's hut. And the same thing with the hunting lodge, and the same thing with the forester. The reason why we did that is because each building gets the most productivity out of the first one or two workers. So the first couple workers in the gatherer's hut are going to gather more food than workers 3 and 4. So when we have a small workforce like this, as long as the building locations are close together like this and well laid out, it really is beneficial to have two buildings being partially worked versus one building that's being maxed out. And our blacksmith is good. So we have our cemetery being worked on. We have no firewood, so we want to get somebody back in there. We have our well being built. I don't need that up there. And we're just waiting for someone to graduate in order to build our second house. Keep expanding our population. And then we'll go ahead and call this episode finished. I think we gave them enough time to run to the herbalist if they wanted to. So we'll get them back working as a laborer. And it'll be nice when I can finally have all these buildings fully staffed. But right now it works. Let's get another forester up. Wood is good. Okay, we have our laborer just graduated, so we'll get this house built, and I need a builder to do that. We still have plenty of food. Firewood, we're going to increase the limit to 500. And we'll do the same for our foresters. And let's also clear out some of these resources, which will help these buildings over here be more productive, and we need them. Okay, great. We have our 17-year-old gatherer and a 15-year-old student, so we should be good on houses for a bit. But as you can see, we're ready to expand as soon as we're able to. Our cemetery is being worked on. They're removing the resources from that now. And yeah, everything is going great. Now, the reason why we started some crop fields over here was twofold. One, we need the resources, and there was a lot of resources in this area. And two, we're going to be trading soon. Probably next episode, actually, we'll be setting up our trading post. And we want to be ready for any new seeds or livestock that we get in. So that's the first step to getting ready, is getting some crop fields laid down. Now, I want to check out my people real quick, because it looks like I had a laborer. Graduate, and if that's the case, I want another house up as soon as possible. But no, I don't know why I keep seeing that. See, double check all these. Oh, it was the 16-year-old. Okay, that's fine. Okay, we don't need another woodcutter yet. And they're still clearing out for our cemetery. And our well. I'm gonna go ahead and slow this down here and take a look. Take a look so we can see what is happening in our town here. We'll go ahead in. And you can see each season they're gathering more. Our one hunter is getting some. Our foresters are busy picking up stone and iron as they're planting trees. what we have going on over here. And they're doing all right. Not too shabby. Not too shabby. We'll put those back. We'll put these three buildings back to work soon. Okay. So while we're waiting for these to be done, we'll see if we can get stocked back up on our tools and coats. Actually, I'm going to raise the limit up to 30 because our population is increasing. And I just saw someone grab an herb out of storage, so... Oh, and there's our influx of people. We have our cemetery ready to go. Just a small one. But that's okay. And our well is just about built. This game really is really beautiful, I think. They did a nice job with it. See everybody going to school. Cutting corners. Walking right through each other, just like The Sims 4. There's no reason to have an herb limit. We're going to go ahead and increase that. And there you go. Our well is complete, which makes me happy as well as the citizens in the perfect town. Okay, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up here. We completed our second Forester's Hub. We got a few luxuries up and running. We have some laborers graduating here. So in the next episode, we'll continue to expand our houses. And we'll also start thinking about getting our trading posts up and running. As well as hopefully getting some agriculture, some farms, and maybe some livestock if we're lucky with our trader. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the episode, and I will see you next time.